Further successes followed, which established the Mullingar man as an international star. But Joe Dolan never forgot his roots and was a silent benefactor to many. He loved a round of golf and always carried his clubs in the boot of his car. In 1987, Mullingar Town Council honoured Joe with the Freedom of Mullingar, the highest accolade the Town Council can bestow on a citizen. It was indeed with great sadness that I, along with his legion of fans, learnt of Joe's untimely death just under a year ago on the 26th of December last. As an outpouring of sorrow filled young and old at his untimely passing, Mullingar Town Council, in conjunction with Westmeath County Council, contacted Joe's family to determine the best way to honour Joe's memory on behalf of the people. It was agreed that a memorial be erected in the centre of the town, and following a selection process, Carl Payne, in association with the Mullingar Company, Genesis Fine Arts, worked tirelessly over the last number of months to create this life-sized, three-dimensional bronze image of Joe, which we will all see for the first time in a few minutes when it is unveiled by our Taoiseach, who so graciously accepted our invitation to carry out this honour. I think Joe would have been humbled to see such a large gathering here today, but above all, he would have been proud to see his family and his friends, to see his devoted fans sharing in this poignant moment. Locals and visitors alike can now share in a nod and a smile with Mullingar's most famous citizen. Joe Dolan now holds a permanent place in his hometown. There may never be another show like a Joe show, and there will never be another entertainer like Joe, but he will always be here in the heart of Mullingar. A few weeks before he died, Joe quoted a Brendan Keneally poem that makes the point that as long as someone is remembered, that person will never die. Joe Dolan will never be forgotten. He will always be remembered the length and breadth of this island of Ireland, and indeed throughout the world. Joe is forever immortalized here in the heart of Mullingar. Thank you, one and all, for all your involvement here today and in making this a memorable occasion. Gurau Mila Mahadev Gurau.
As Cathaoirleach said, we are honoured and delighted that an invitation which was extended to the Taoiseach to officially unveil the sculpture was accepted. So I am pleased to ask on Taoiseach, Mr. Brian Cowan, to address you.
Well, as many years ago, there, Cathaoirleach and Corda Conde, Cathaoirleach and Corda Balea, a Gafta, a Ganadori, a Corridori, as many years ago, there, County Dolan, and as many years ago, people in Gardens and Counter more input. It's more on an ordom, a very I'm asking you, from a gallop new asha, a chamoran sail, fjodol, enough to. A coos war, love rone, boss, joe, and nori. A fugue will say imaha, or see in the fearna. Ta ira fjol, yo, fahaha, to foe. Ta winter will impair, and as winter in the heron, on bodul as. And as Danion were our own Eve, he threw up his call there of food in the clinic. He yarnished a rude reel, or a valley yukish. Her noy, he draw more at the dog. And as his core, who will on Dal's shot, Lunaha, he grill or on Valley's shot. He mask a card, agus bhí meas na mína a bhfuil an méid sin meas air. Ladies and gentlemen, Chairman of Westmeath County Council, Chairman of Westmeath Town Council, Deputy O'Rourke, Senator Cassidy, Senator Glenn, Deputy Penrose, councillors, Green Usa Galair, members of the Dolan family. It's a great honour for me to be here today to commemorate the life of Mullingar's most famous son, the late Joe Dolan. Joe was one of Ireland's best-loved singers and entertainers. But while he himself is so sadly no longer with us, he has left our country and the wider world a lasting musical legacy. And what's important in life, of course, is what we make, that we make the best use of our talents. And Joe Dolan's talent was his music. His life was his music. And throughout his charisma, his boundless energy, his tremendous heart and talent, he won admiration and respect far and wide and enriched the lives of so many people. And those old enough to remember the golden era of the Irish show bands would recall how Joe and his brother Ben, with their musical family background, took their first steps into that heady and competitive show band scene with the wonderful Drifter show band. Lucky for us that they did so, and lucky for us also that Joe didn't keep the day job. His first milestone, and has been said, a fitting prelude to things to come, was his song Answer to Everything, which reached number 4 in the charts. And by the end of the 60s, his timeless classic, Make Me an Island, went on to number 1 in no less than 14 countries. And from there on in, the world was his oyster, and his destiny was sealed. People everywhere enjoyed a succession of Joe Dolan favourites, many of which were record-breaking hits. The popularity of Irish music on the world stage was a phenomenon that only really took hold from the 1980s onwards. But Joe was an artist well ahead of his time and captivated audiences across the globe long before that. His remarkable ability to do so was demonstrated beyond any doubt when a decade before Glasnost, he became the first Western artist ever to perform in the Soviet Union. And there too, in a country so different from our own, he went down a storm. We've seen enormous change in the Irish music scene over the decades. A multitude of bands, literally hundreds of them, have come and gone. They've had their day in the sun, in the dance halls, in the disco hotels, in the nightclubs of Ireland. And in time, many were overtaken as new and emerging trends took centre stage. But all of them have their place in the history of entertainment. And they've all paved the way for our success as a country with so much to offer the world on the music scene. But one constant throughout all of that period has been Joe Dolan, whose inimitable style is as dearly loved by the audiences of the last 10 years as those of the swinging 60s. He was a man of the people. He was the man for every generation, never failing to connect with his audiences. And he was a tremendous live entertainer. And as each decade heralded in new musical trends, which challenged even the most gifted performers, Joe transformed those challenges into opportunities, breathing new life into a diverse range of contemporary hits through his albums, Joe's 90s and 21st Century Joe, and continuing on with a number of great new CDs and shows until last year. His energy, talent, and enthusiasm enabled him to remain at the heart of the music scene as few others have done. And while Joe was a star of international acclaim, he never forgot his roots or the loyal band of followers and well-wishers here, where he took his first steps into the music scene. The location of this statue at the heart of this town reflects his place at the core of Mullingar life and of Irish life too. Commissioned by Genesis Fine Arts, it is a very fitting memorial to one of Ireland's most outstanding musical icons. The sculptor Carl Payne is already renowned for his bronze sculptures of many famous people. This one does him great credit yet again, and I've no doubt that people will agree that the statue is very true to life. It's timely that Joe's biography has recently been launched, written by Roland Casey, son of Joe's longtime manager Seamus, and prefaced by Ben. It is an entertaining and revealing account of his life. It should make a wonderful present for Joe's many fans this Christmas, as indeed should the Platinum Collection, which has been advertised recently also.